Hello everybody, they call me Muse and I welcome you back to Hitman Freelancer and the Accident Only Challenge, where last time out we made slow but steady progress. We got through the first three missions without too much bother, apart from a little bit of a shootout in Bangkok that we ran away from. There's a whole lot of studying the patterns of our NPCs before we acted, which is well and good. Okay, so the espionage has got four fresh missions for us. There's a chance that we'll get Firewire Kill, which is sad, because we won't be doing that. But yeah, four new missions would be nice. So let's see what we've got. So we've got Marrakesh, we've got Alerted Mumbai, and then we've got Haven, and we've got Hokkaido. So is it Haven for the showdown, or is it Marrakesh? It's probably Haven. I do like a good Haven showdown. So let's start with a bit of Alerted Mumbai, perhaps. We'll take Silent Assassin, because that's pretty much our only option there. We'll bring along the old oil canister. And yeah, we've got everything we need, I think. Wrench, screwdriver, all the good stuff. Let's go to Mumbai. Right, are we on Illusions of Grandeur again? The construction site is blocked off, so that's not an option. We've got two targets, and they are in and around the train yard, so we probably only need one disguise. Is there anywhere we can pick one up without causing an accident? There's a local security in the Chul, for sure. There's a movie outfit in the laundry, but that's no use. So what do we need?
Long time no see.
Oh, I didn't bring a banana, did I? What a foolish fool. How am I supposed to make people fall over without a banana of my own? Can I find one anywhere in the slums here? You'd think there'd be like food stands around where I could find one, but off the top of my head I don't know where. So maybe we'll just press on for the moment. Now, does the tailor outfit let us in? It does, doesn't it? Where does the tailor live? He lives there.
He's the only tailor in town that can make that damn dress.
That's what happens when you drop on all the others, I guess.
So, is there a way of making the tailor suffer an accident? We got the tailor.
Listen, I have to go out for a while.
Just hanging around down there. If we could lure him up to the roof. But then there's also those two up there, so we can't really shove him off anything from up there. Yeah, getting the tailor outfit could be tricky. If only I'd brought a Nana along. Oh well, we haven't, so let's abandon that plan for the moment and stroll about. Oh, wait a minute, I did bring a Prox Taser though, so I could potentially just electrocute a guard and get his gear. Now, one of our targets is inside, but the other one is out. So potentially they can be electrocuted. If we can get to them without getting spotted, that is. And if they're on their own. And they're not patrolling with a chum. And of course they're patrolling with a chum. I mean, potentially we could still electrocute them. It's just that we probably can't then take their outfit because their mate is going to move the body. Oil drum, you say? We could puncture that. And then they're going to come over. And then we've got a coin. That we could toss in there. And potentially, we can get away with this.
Amazing.
Oh dear. Looks like someone's burned to death.
I think it was an accident.
Yeah, it was.
Okay, got it.
Right, so that's his mate taken care of. Which means there's now going to be no witnesses when we take care of this lad. Now, where do those other two guards patrol? Because if they don't go terribly far... Okay. I thought it was concealed there, but maybe I wasn't. I was going to say, maybe we could take them out behind that shipping crate in the distance there. But they might spot that. So maybe I wait for him to come over here, and then I throw the taser into the bush. He goes and picks it up, falls over dead. And then hopefully we can strip him of his gear. Alright, so he's the only one around. Yep. You best go and check out that sound you just heard, my friend. Oh yeah, we lost Silent Assassin. I'd already forgotten that I selected it. But really, it was never going to happen with those two guys next to one another.
All right.
There we go. Bot number two down. And we got ourselves an outfit. Now let's stroll on in. So don't get spotted, take no damage. Poison target, dart gun are still all on the cards. Although this outfit probably won't allow us into that inner sanctum area where our target is, so maybe it wasn't even worth getting this outfit. Because, yeah, we're trespassing in here. But at least we can take out the cameras. Do we sneak around to the bits we are allowed in? And then see if we can't get a shot on our target with the dart gun from around there. Maybe we do that. Maybe we also leave our briefcase here, because I don't think that's required at this stage. And then if we can't see our target from around here, we climb up top maybe, and we try and get an elite guard outfit by pushing some dude over a ledge. But there's our target. She's just roaming about. That kind of works. I mean,
everything seems fine.
We didn't make her ill, did we? Oh, we did make her ill. Good. Where are you going, friend? She's going over there somewhere. Maybe we punch her this just in case. Let's pop down a coin. Shall we? Pop down a couple of coins, and when she comes back we can set her on fire. Lovely. Right, she's on her way back. Good.
Huh?
Huh? Surely that's not a trap.
Wow, that's awesome.
And the other one?
Glad to see something going right for once.
Yes. And we got it. Lovely. I wasn't sure if she was close enough to the oil patch. But turns out she was. And another victim is claimed. And 47 can go about his nefarious business elsewhere. Assuming, of course, we get out of here without getting spotted. But at this stage, it's just a little jog. So we should be fine.
Yes.
Lovely. That's a nice smooth start then. Even if we did forget the banana. But that's cool. Sometimes you just don't need an army. So moving on. Marrakesh, one target. Hokkaido, one target. Poison guard, don't blow disguise, no firearms. Yeah, we'll get Hokkaido out of the way. There is time silent takedown. There is silent assassin. No firearms. Now, time silent takedown, maybe? We're not going to have much opportunity to take down anyone other than the target, though, unless we get lucky with an accident. We're a silent assassin, no firearms. Means that we're leaving the dart gun at home. Let's go silent assassin, no firearms. It'd be nice to get a silent assassin at some point. Now, so that means... Well, we want a syringe to syringe a guard. Let's bring an emetic along. What reward are we picking up from our crate, by the way? Is it a taser? No, it's a remote flash. That's less useful. In that it's generally completely useless. But we do still have a micro taser. We've got a water canister. And we've got enough space for a nana. So, don't blow your disguise and no firearms fit nicely with the prestige. Poison guard just involves syringing a bugger at some point. Yeah, this could be doable. One would hope so. That's the whole point. Let's see what we can do. Yeah, nice refreshing spa. Okay, so where does our target reside today? They are outside of 47's room. We could lure them into 47's room and then make them fall over on a banana. And then drag them to the balcony and throw them off. Then it would work. Let's see. Director? Right. Although they're a bit further up than our room, actually.
Good evening.
They're there. Okay. We've only got one nana, so we can only make one person slip. Ah, there we go. He's run past our room. Now, is that other guard going to see us if we do anything untoward? Who heard that? The other guy. That's no good. Maybe I just timed that poorly.
I hope you're enjoying your stay.
If this guy comes back... I mean, potentially we could syringe him and then follow him into a toilet and drown him. But if he comes back and we time it right, we might be able to lure him into our rooms. And then we've also got that guard. Yeah, maybe we lure that guard in to get rid of him. Yeah, that should cause this guy to fall over.
Okay, what's that?
Yeah, take time, friend. There we go. Good. So that's this guy out of the way. Or at least it would be if we could pick him up, which we can't. Maybe he's snagged on our briefcase somehow. But now that he's out of the way, if we cause any more audio distractions, it will be the guy that we're looking for on his way past. And then we syringe him, and then we deal with him. So I guess we just wait for him to do a little circuit. Of course, if we botch it, then we're just going to be sat here waiting for 5 minutes for him to come back around again. And that would be unfortunate. Okay, target's on the move. Now is probably a good time. Nope, he didn't hear that. What else can we throw?
What?
Yeah, he heard that. Good.
Let me take care.
Now, a emetic syringe. Let's get that ready.
Huh?
He's going to see the briefcase. And he's been poisoned. Although he doesn't seem to have cared that he's been poisoned because he's wandering off with my briefcase. This is unfortunate.
Enjoying your stay.
But maybe he's just going to take it up to the security office, drop it off, and then realise that he's sick. And then he'll go to the bathroom? What's he doing? Yes, he's realized he's sick, so he's going to probably come to this bathroom over here. So he might be alright. Okay, so we've ended up with another toilet drowning. But that's fine. That's the first one of this video. We may as well cover this lad. Can we get our briefcase back is the question. Right, so that guy goes back and forth between the security room and the main part of the office. That's fine. Does he then come back outside? Maybe he does. Maybe we scuttle away. Okay, he can't see us there. Good. Briefcase is ours. Can we get out before he sees us? Good. Lovely stuff. We actually did a silent assassin, no firearms. And we're going to get away with it.
Client lock, couple of months.
Yes, a good situation. Miss Yamazaki's very smart. Very capable.
Away we go. We had a plan. We executed it and it actually came off. Lovely job. Remesimetic, that's fine, I guess, but it's not the micro-taser I was hoping for. No biggie, we've got Marrakesh to do. Don't blow your disguise, poison guard, don't get spotted. Silent assassin is an option again. Let's go for that. And let's see, although, Do we really want to go for Silent Assassin? Because there is a fun thing to do on Marrakesh that I enjoy. But then, time to get disguises. Yeah, we've only got one target, so Silent Assassin's probably the best. We'll have to save the great big electrocution pile for a later Marrakesh. We'll try and do it at least once more during this playthrough. Because I do enjoy the big electrocution pile of Marrakesh. You'll see when we get to it. You'll all see. Now. 13 of 15. We've got the dart gun that we need for poisoning. Don't get spotted, don't blow your disguise. Maybe we're alright. And maybe we'll just grab a nana. Just because it comes in handy. Now we'll take the old hit van and head to the airport. Oh, jeez. The worst starting location. Ah, it's the one just after Strandberg's died. So it's not the regular version of the map. It's an elusive target version. And our target is in Market Square. So let's just leave this area. There's no disguises hanging around that we might need. And out we go. Yep, don't mind me, friends. So yeah, no protesters about. It's like sunset. It's definitely a non-standard version of Marrakesh.
Won't get out of hand.
Now, whereabouts are the things we might need to unlock this safe? Because we've almost got enough to buy one of those legendary items. We might have enough to buy the sword if it shows up. I always have trouble finding the items, though, when the safe is in this spot on this version of the map, because it's like, are they in the market or what? Right, there's a target. I should have bought some lethal poison, to be honest. Where's the mark going? It's looking at some carpets. So yeah, I guess we'll follow the mark, and if we happen to see the third safe thing, we'll grab it. Right, so he has a lengthy conversation with the rug salesman, then he walks past a scooter that we could potentially create an oil leak for, but then where could we shoot that oil without being spotted? Now, is he going to sample some delicious snail meat, maybe? Is he just going to have lengthy conversations with everyone that he passes? Because if he is... Nope, good. I was going to say that'd be annoying. Right, so we're coming round here, and that's an electrocution opportunity, for sure.
Good day to you.
If we can get a handyman outfit, we can get away with it. Do we need to even keep following him at this point? I don't think so. I think I'll get him with that.
Oh, hi,
So where is the handyman disguise? Is it just down here? Is it here on this version of the map? No. Well, that's that plan. Buggered. So he has to look around all this stuff. And then he just goes back this way. Okay. Right, so he walks across the puddle again. Although, did I bring a remote micro taser? Because if I did, and I just drop it on the puddle, no one sees it because it's all micro. I think that's how it works. Although, no, they see the proximity micro one, don't they? So, Alright, so he walks past those bikes. That guy's snoozing. So he wouldn't see me cause an oil leak. And he looks at some plates. Yeah, can it hurt to quickly, whilst no one's around, create an oil leak? No, I don't think that can hurt. Now, let's follow the mark some more. And then I think, yeah, he's pretty much done a full circuit there of what he's going to do. Now, where is that final tablet slash laptop that I need? There's a propane flask there. Even better. I keep forgetting about propane flasks being an option. But they absolutely are, and they do make life easy. So yeah, he's just looking at some spices now. Still no sign of that final tablet, though. Alright, our target seems to have given up on moving for the moment. He's just going to stand here like a pleb for a while. Very well, we'll check in on him in a bit. Let's go make sure we remember exactly where we've caused that oil leak. It's next to the sleeping waiter. So yeah, it's after the pottery. So there's the oil leak. So how do we hit it without getting caught in the blast? And which way does he walk? He walks from that way over here. So he'll probably see us. Maybe we get rid of the waiter. Because I think that should get rid of the waiter completely. Maybe it won't though, on this version of the map. Maybe he'll just go back to sleep. Could do without all these other people wandering back and forth. Right, so the waiter is going about his business. So he's out of the picture for now. But is he going to return here after he's dropped off General Zaydan's food? That's another question we need to answer. Is that the final tablet we need? Probably. Lovely. So we will snag that. Now, our target is just standing here now. Is he just stuck? Has he done a loop and now he just doesn't move? That would be unfortunate. That would limit our options somewhat. There's no high ground or anything where we can snipe him without being seen. So we can't exactly seeker him. Yeah, there's no way we're getting away with a seeker shot from over here or anything like that. Bugger. I mean, we still need to poison a guard. So we could go and look at that. Oh, it's the Angel of Death. Hello, madam. At least she's not on our case today. Now, this guard's an ideal target, I would imagine. The poisoning. There's none hiding in this corner anywhere. And Now, if we poison that guy, is he just going to come in here and vom into that bin? Because if he is... then we possibly put a banana on the floor and get his outfit. Nope, he's going elsewhere. Okay. Maybe he's going to Shisha.
Hi, oh, what's wrong? You look awful.
Which means it's still not impossible that we make him slip. Yeah. Yeah, he's coming over to the restrooms. There is somewhere to hide bods in here. So perhaps we still go ahead with the slipping plan. Whoops. Down he goes. Now at the very least we are a guard. Does that help us? Maybe we can move our man by dropping a gun near him and then bumping him so he sees it. And he'll go and tell a guard and that'll shake him out of his routine. Or shake him back into his routine.
Yes, sir! Yes,
sir! Sorry, excuse me. You seem to have forgot something.
Right, are you gonna pay enough attention to that? Right, it looks like we might have kick-started his routine again. He's at least talking now rather than just standing still. Good, he's on the move. Now where's he going? He does have a lengthy route, this dude. Maybe I'm better off just secreting him at some point.
I salute you.
Right, Angel of Death is still on the move with her guards. So she might end up being a problem just because one of her guards sees through my kit. No. Nope, shopkeep. Not an ideal time to seek for someone. And he's on the move again already. Alright, where are we going now, Rolf? His name's Rolf, by the way. In case you were unaware of this. We're coming over here. Can I just lure you into a room and then seek you? Not like that, I can't.
Let's find out what that was.
Okay.
Okay, we've lured someone in. And now he's gone on his next mission. He seems to be going to different spots this time, so it's like he's got one big long route where he just goes all the way around the map, like, twice.
Hi, recruit.
So I'm just wondering, for the sake of brevity, if I just seek the bugger. There's still people everywhere. Marrakesh is known for its people.
I'm surprised the guys at work.
But there we go. As much as I don't want to just seek people left and right and then drown them in toilets, there's a limit to my patience. And we are right by the bog, so why not? Sorry, Rolf. It was going to be something cool like an explosion, but you just took too damn long to do anything. Now get in the box. We'll put on our flashy purple suit once again. Maybe pop in and see a friend supplier. You gotta love it when the supplier is right by the exit. Makes life much easier. Right then, shopkeep. I will take your finest samurai sword. And I'll also take your emetic syringe, because that might actually be useful.
Thank you. You know where I am.
and away. And another silent assassin. And so, Haven awaits. With no firearms, I believe. Let's double check that. Six targets, one disguise, no firearms, don't get spotted. So, silent assassin, no firearms? Nope. Eliminate leader during tell, smoker and foodie. Wow. Smokers are our friend. Because we can make it very bad for their health. We'll drop off the seeker. Because no firearms. Do we keep the emetic syringe? I mean, they're also a foodie, so maybe we bring poison. So we bring poison. We bring probably the oil canister. One disguise could easily be a food server, if we can find one, who doesn't mind us taking their outfit in an accidental fashion. So we'll bring the oil canister. We got oil canister, we got poison. We got wrenches and lockpicks. We got everything we might need, I think. It's just a case of identifying the correct target. So we're looking for a blonde, hatless glasses wearer with necklace and earrings. And beautiful Haven awaits. I didn't bring a banana. What an idiot. Although, if there's any map where I could probably find a banana without too much trouble, I think it's Haven. Now, let's see. You're not blonde. You're not blonde. Good. That's two targets off the list already. There's two more over here at ground level. So let's go and have a peek at them, shall we? Now, you are a redhead, so you're off the list. And you had a hat, so you're off the list. So we're down to two targets already. One over on the beach and one up there. Should we ID them before we do anything else? It's probably a wise idea. So that one's heading down towards where the other one is on the beach. They're blonde. They've got glasses. They've got a necklace. Is that an earring? I think that's an earring you're wearing. Yeah. Alright, so you're prime suspect for now. But let's just check your friend, shall we? You also might fit the bill.
Huh?
Sorry, madam. I just want to... Yeah, you also fit the bill. Why do I keep pressing escape?
Whoa, easy does it.
Right, so we've got two targets. Either could be the one. We're looking for a smoking foodie. Yeah, where's that lookout going? Smoko, eh? Right next to a guard. But it's a good sign. We just need to see if you're going to pop into one of these villas and eat something. That would be very convenient for us. Yeah, is this our hook? It's the shark hook.
Pardon, sir.
Yep, we're allowed in here. He's apparently allowed in here, or so he thinks. But what's he up to? He's reading a book. You, sir, have just saved yourself from a murder. And we know who our target is now. Therefore, let's go and find the bugger. They're over there. On the beach. At some point, they're going to have a tasty beverage. Where are they going to get that beverage from when they're over here? Are you going to go over to the huts? Or are you drinking from over here somewhere? There is... Oh no, it's a foodie, isn't it? Not a... Yeah, so that's her food. Okay. So she's just eaten it, which is unfortunate, but it's not the end of the world. We'll wait for Lookout to bugger off, though, before we risk poisoning it. I could technically go and get a frog. But I'm not sufficiently bothered by the loss of a poison vial to do that. I'd rather just poison this and then... Then what? Just wait for an exit, I guess. Lovely. What is that anyway? Some sort of tropical fruit? Yeah, it looks almost like it's got a bit of a butt in it, so it might be a peach. Now, look how it's going to come back, but we're going to stroll away. Now, I don't think that other lookout is likely to go up to the exit point, so we can just stroll over there and bide our time, I feel. There's that lookout. The one to which I refer. And that's pretty much it done. Haven once again proves to be one of the very best showdown locations. Where does Haven rank then on my tier list? Because originally I put it at like D. But that's because I was just being an idiot. And I kept trying to snipe people and whatnot. And then just getting spotted from halfway across the map. By guards. But when you play it sensibly, and when you consider how it can quite easily be done, with restrictions like suit only, no firearms, things of that nature. Because so much of it is open and public, and your targets generally roam around there. It's probably at least A tier. Maybe at some point I will update my tier lists. Probably won't do a full video on it, but maybe I'll bring up an image or something to show where we stand. Right, so it looks like our target's standing very still, so she is currently in a meeting, I believe. She might be smoking, but it looked like a little movement of her arms there. So yeah, I feel like she's in a meeting. After she's done with that, she's going to go and have a nice tasty fruit. And that will be her downfall. Wind's getting up a bit. There's a storm coming. I'd appreciate it if she finishes her business so I can bugger off before I get wet. I do like the dynamic weather changes on Haven though, how the weather will change in the campaign map after you've killed two of the three targets. And the thunderstorm rolls in. There's a few weather changes in this latest version of Freelancer as well. There's a new New York variation finally. It's, as far as I know, it's midday. And it's after the stock market has crashed. So it's not hugely varied, but it's a start. And there's been a few changes to Wick Creek as well, where they've added like a sunset version, I think, and the serial killer elusive target's been moved to that version. And the nighttime version is now the bonus mission, a bitter pill. So a lot of the houses are locked up and there's more cameras about. So it'd be intriguing to see that at some point. I don't usually keep night maps on, but I have done so for that version of Wick Creek because it'll be something new. And that, after all, is the whole point of Freelancer variations. You're right there, madam. You appear to be having some sort of allergic reaction to that fruit. Oh dear, she fell down. What a terrible shame. We should go and take this boat and see if we can find a doctor somewhere. Now, is that going to count as our 25th accident? It seems like poison doesn't count as an accident in Freelancer, so no. We've made a bit more progress towards getting the frog, but we still haven't got the Puzzle Master Chief. Very well. What we have done, though, is completed the second level of this campaign, and we've earned ourselves a striker, which we lost at some point, as can happen with the loud guns. Some money would have been nice, but so be it. We'll get back our poison, because that could definitely come in handy next time. And next time is when we will see more of our bold friend as he ventures into level 3 of the Accident Only Challenge. Until then, thanks for watching, friends.